Hello, it's me again, Wolfram Kreis from the European Mainstream Academy. And in the next video clip, I want to talk about one part of mainframe security, cryptography, and how it's supported by the hardware. Data are the most important assets. I think you agree to that statement, though data and programs must be protected, and this is true protection from external people, customers, partners, hackers, of course, as well for internal workforce. And there are rules. We have the Global Data Protection Rules. We have Sarbanes-Oxley. We have the Payment Card Industry Data Security Standard with 12 requirements. And two of these requirements are to protect stored data, means data at rest in the mainframe environment. And another requirement is protect data that is on the fly, means transmission of cardholder data across open public networks. And we have HIPAA. This is a Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act. And you have to be compliant with all these regulations and rules. When we think about the evolution of security in the mainframe environment, in the past, there were only a handful highly skilled experts that had access to a mainframe. And if you want to steal some data, you have to get into this closed job. It is normally was normally impossible, and you had to steal the punch card decks. Not that easy. During time, it has become much easier to create and access data on mainframes. Today, the mainframes are connected via TCP/IP to the internet, though security, of course, in this case is really an issue. And protection of data, I think you agree, is very important today. Logical access control is integrated in COS. I come to that in the next video clip. And in this video clip, I want to talk about the encryption. And especially with C14, the most current machine at these times, pervasive encryption with IBM C was introduced. So it means that the cryptography technologies are integrated into the hardware. This is only partly new. The CPEC F is available for a long time. It means the CPU assist of cryptographic functions. We have the next generation of the Crypto Express card. This is an optional card for additional get better performance for cryptographic functions. We have the possibility to secure not only data in flight. In flight means when we transmit data via networks. We also can very easily now with pervasive encryption, very easily protect data at rest, means the data that are within the mainframe environment. Means data in Linux file systems or data in COS data sets. Also, protection of data in the clustering environment is supported. It means the protection of data in the coupling facilities. Coupling facilities, the memory that is shared between different operating systems in a cluster environment, in a sysplex, parallel sysplex, GDPS environment on mainframes. Also, of course, network protect traffic protection is assured. We have the possibility to implement secure service containers, also a very important new possibility to get an even higher security as before. Okay, here we see the hardware that implements the cryptographic environment on our IBM mainframes. We have the physical machine on the left side here, and within these physical machines we have the drawers, And on these drawers we have the processing units. Processing units can be characterized in different types. And these processing units are on the single chip modules. And on each of these processing units, each of these processors has a cryptographic extension. It's a central processing assist cryptographic function. It's a co-processor on each and every PU already installed to assist cryptographic functions. And additional and as an option, we can have crypto express cards in the PCIe environment in the slots here. And these crypto express cards also bring a much higher performance on cryptographic functions and processing. And additional, also as an option, we have the trusted key entry. It's an environment where we can get keys into our mainframe environment. The CP assist for cryptographic functions. Again, here you see the single chip module. These are, as I already said, available on each and every processor already installed. PU, the processing unit, can be defined as the central processor, as an integrated facility for Linux. Linux as a CAAP. CAAP are no longer available, but important today are the SIPs, the information integration processors. The CPEC-F functionality is supported by nearly all operating systems running on mainframe. It means on COS, on CVM, on C, VSE, on CTPF, and on Linux on C systems. The cryptographic functions that are supported with hashing functions, you see all the standards that are implemented and supported, and also important is the random number generation possibility for generating random numbers and message authentication. And the coprocessor, the CP assist for cryptographic functions, supports encryption, decryption of clear and protected key operations for each cryptographic functions, secure socket layer, transport layer security, virtual private networks, IPsec, and so on. You see each and every possibilities are available, and each and every standards are supported. This was the first part concerning the more detailed information about security. And in the next part, I talk about the security within the operating system. For questions and remarks, please use, as always, our discussion forum on the OpenHPI platform. Thank you very much for attending, and hope to see you in the next video clip.